he peers across the street at the sad little motel by the liquor store. Its pale facade is almost featureless, except for two irregular rows of tiny bathroom windows. He gets out, presses his key fob, and hears his car's lock beep behind him. Rounding the corner of Vermont, he comes to the building's front gateway. He starts in recognition. Is that the girl he saw in the photograph ahead of him right now, flitting up the steps to the open walkway of the motel's upper level, glancing back down at him with laughing eyes full of sassy flirtation and sunlight? She disappears from his view as she crests the top step and runs on along the walkway, triggering his memory of that other gaze stabbing into him from behind her face. And along with this advent of Evelyn, Jamie's perceptions come swinging down from the house on Electra Drive to here in Westmont. So distracted has he been by Kim's inner life, he's been forgetting to attend to her and Amber. Ignoring the opaque grilled windows of the motel's ground floor office on his left, Dard starts barreling up the flight of steps in pursuit of her. By the time he has heaved himself up to the upper walkway, it's deserted. One of the blue-grey doors on the left appears to be open just a crack, though. He runs along to the door, grabs its handle, and pushes it inwards.